It's one of those games that really doesn't like being kept in the background, so... Anyway, all the wounded are fixed up, so that means we are going to go back to the curing blessing. So, yeah, back to the game, and things are looking a little better. Mood is contented, so it's fallen again, but contented is okay. Farmers feel resolved, the weapon things feel secure, so people are kind of happy with how things are at the moment. Looks like we've got too many hunters again. I'm gonna have to do something about that. Yeah, we'll bring that back down to 43. And there we go. Oh dear. Our killer, a member of the Lyseng Ring, comes looking for warriors willing to join a hunting party. Their Tuler is being terrorized by a gigantic and dangerous creature called the Black Worm. They will pay 3 cows worth of goods to each warrior willing to help. They need up to 5 warriors. Anyone wanting to convince a worm must be able to think like a worm. I think I can do it. I know the ways of the dragon newts and their kin. I can convince him to move along. The farmers fear worms, but the bravest might be willing to accompany the weapon thanes. If we could talk to the worm and convince it to move along, our ancestors would bless us. Put 4 cows each for a warrior is as high as she will go. There's no law saying that we must help everyone menaced by a giant lizard. If we lead the hunting party, we'll have more control over what happens to our warriors. So, do we send a party to convince the worm to move along? Do we send warriors, but at a higher price? Do we offer to take full responsibility for killing the worm? Do we refuse her or send warriors to hunt and kill the worm? Now, it's worth noting what Offair says here. I know the ways of the dragon newts and their king. I can convince him to move along. We are favourable towards dragons and their smaller brethren, so sending warriors would go against our clan history, which is kind of important to keep in mind. So I don't think sending warriors is a good idea for us. Your ring is more invested in talking to the worm because of the dragon friend history. Yes, exactly. Ophir's name literally means victim. I didn't know that. Oh dear. He may just be a scaly. Well, he may be. But if he's a scaly, then technically so are we. Because we are dragon friends. So let's send a party to convince the worm to move along. And who do we send to do the convincing? No, I've noticed I can't actually change the order the game sorts it. We could send Beneva. Beneva said she could convince the worm to move along. But Ophir also says that he can convince the worm to move along. Yeah, get upset ancestors for killing it. Yeah, I think so too. So it's between either Ophir or Beneva. I I would say off air is probably the better one to talk, to do the talking here. I mean, heroic customs and excellent leadership. Good with magic as well. Not so good with animals, but yeah, I'm thinking this is either leadership or custom, or and yeah, magic may be involved as well. So I think we'll go with off here. See how that goes. Oh dear, it's asking us to send Ains and footmen. Well, I don't see any problem sending large numbers out right now, so we'll send 10 weapon thanes out and send all the available footmen. It should be fine. The fields have plenty of farmers working them, so yeah. How much do you give the worm? Okay. Well, I don't particularly want to give it cows, but I've just noticed we've got 931 cows. That's a lot more than I was expecting to see. So maybe we do give them some cows, and yeah, 10 cattle, 50 goods, maybe. I think something like 100 would be a guaranteed success. But I think 50 would put us in a good situation here. We'll go with this. Ophir sought out the worm and told it that it was unfairly unharming people of the clan Lysang. It replied that people were interlopers in Dragonpass, and that we should not count ourselves lucky that the dragonkin confined their eating to a few farm animals. Oh dear. Well, that didn't go so well. Oh well. Not much we can do about that, but it took the gifts. Cacophony of cows howling in fear gets closer to the wormlet. Hey dude, you want some snacks? Oh man. And of course we've got yet another hunter suddenly appear. Oh well. It's still sea season, so maybe we reduce the pasture a little bit and expand the wildlands. Not changing the okay. I think whatever it is, we're at our limit then. So yeah, we'll keep it at that. Right. Next up then. We need to make a blessing to the ancestors. Now's a good time to do that, and we've got plenty of cows now, so we can sacrifice cows again. And, interesting. Summons of evil. Summons our ancient enemies so that we can defeat them. Interesting. We could perform a divination. We can learn whether there are still treasures hidden on the Tula. I think we'll go with that. And 9 cows? Yeah, 9 cows. Our ancestors report that there are more treasures to be found in our Tula. Oh, good job we looked then. So, right, very well. It is fire season. I think by this point we have definitely lost the bonus from the rainbow event. So I think that's worth keeping in mind. So I don't think we need to go quite so heavy on the trading that we did previously. With that said, do we want to go trading or do we want to go hunting for treasure? I kind of want to go hunting for treasure now that I know that there is definitely more treasures. Well, I say definitely. Nothing is definite in King of Dragon Pass. There are more treasures on our Tula, so yeah, let's make sure that we've got the tracking blessing going, and we've got the Pathfinder blessing going. That should help us, and we'll explore once again, Randella. We'll keep you on the Tula. Pretty much, yeah, we'll go with that. See what happens. And there we go. The party we sent to explore the Tula found an odd rock crystal that is, which is warm to the touch. This is a tear shed by Chilana Aroy's son, Aroyn. It has great healing powers. I have seen that a rock will speak to one of our farmers. Okay, Thea. Speaking of which, Thea. It might be worth us reorganizing the clan at this point. I'm not too happy that we don't have a trickster on the ring. And I think getting an Alder worshipper on the ring instead of old the Bantar worshipper Elmanti here might be in our best interests as well. Although he is heroic with plants, so let's reorganise. We'll see what happens. It's always good to reorganise every once in a while. And, well, Thea's magic. Plants is fair, though. So that might suffer a little bit. Do we have a Yermal worshipper? We do not. We still don't have a trickster. That's an issue. But I still kind of want to switch Elmalanti for Aya. Look at his stats. When did he level up? One of the reasons I want Bea on the ring is, well, I mean, she's 19, so she's going to get quite a bit of experience over time. So while she's on the ring, she will gain experience. And there is an older hero quest. But I don't think there's one for Barntar. As I was saying earlier, the only image I could find of Barntar is one of him in the background during Arnalda's hero quest. So, yeah, while he's a good farming god to have on the ring, or represented on the ring, he doesn't do us much good in terms of hero quests. So, yeah, I'm going to... Game, why did you do that? There we go. So now we got 4 women, 3 men on the ring. I don't think... Yeah, we've got Enderos and we've got Beneva, our 2 best combatants, on the ring, so that's not going to be that helpful. Bargaining. It's kind of tempting to put Coleman on the ring now. Now, here's my reasoning. Badessa is the better trader, so we can afford to send her out on trade deals if... we have someone else on the ring. Because, well, as I've said before, I do not like sending people on the clan ring out on missions. That's a good way to lose your clan ring in a hurry. So, yeah. I think Vodessa's probably better suited to be a trader, especially with the ring composition as it is. Animals, best represented already here. Yeah. Combat, best already represented well. Custom. Yeah. It's good there. Our clan leader is the best we've got. That is true, Ellie. Coleman is much older, but he's still got at least 7 years on the ring. And so, you know, and then after that, he could die at any moment from old age. And yeah, it's always difficult at this point when you've got a fair spread of men and women on the ring, but because it's an odd number, you'll always have one leaning more than the other. And yeah, having a fair split of men and women on the clan ring, it does have an effect on your clan magic. So yeah, I don't know what that effect is, but I have seen several instances of people saying that that is definitely the case. Different sources as well. It's not just saying that on the wiki. As we have discovered in the past, the wiki can be quite inaccurate. Magic representation is pretty good. And plants representation. Could be better. Okay, then. So, what say you, chat? We'll go back to bargaining. We'll have a look at the split. Do we have Callerman on the ring? Or do we have Vordessa on the ring? I'm very useful here, and I like giving people the benefit of my opinion. Now that I have the chance to serve on the ring, my destiny is shining brightly. yeah. It's always a weird juggling act, this bit. But I'll leave it up to you guys. What do you think? Should we... Actually, I'm going to put a poll up for this. There we go, Vordessa or Callerman. And I will give that I'll give it 2 minutes and there we go. Okay, I'm back and it looks like the there we go, okay. Fair enough. We'll keep Vordessa on the ring. The vote came in just as I got back. Right, so Callerman is much older than her. Yeah, frankly, keep Vord in the ring for growth and send Callerman as he's has the better combat stat. Yeah, you're not wrong. That is a good argument. Since he's older, you can afford to treat him as an expect. Yeah, okay. I hear your wisdom. And I shall concede. Okay, right, here we go. So, Vordessa's back on the ring. And, yeah. I guess that's it then. I mean, it's a real shame that we don't have an Uramal, worshipper amongst the nobles. I mean, I don't mind having Enderos on the ring. He's pretty solid and good with combat, and a lot better with magic than I would expect him to be. Vordessa is getting good leadership. That is true. Where is she? There she is. Yeah, very good. So, yeah. Okay, we'll just have that switch then. So, all we've done is switched Amalunti for Thea. So that is going to change the way the clan operates slightly, but I think both Barntar and Ernaldo worshippers give you a pip in crops at sacred time, so it's not going to be a huge change. But the way the gender split has changed, it's probably going to change the way the magic works. How, I guess we'll just have to wait and see. Anyway, we got a new treasure. Heals wounds on the battlefield. Oh, okay. So we got first aid kit here. Getting a bit late on my end. Might toddle off. Okay, well, thanks for sticking around for as long as you did then, Fist. Glad you enjoyed the stream, and I will see you in the next one. Yeah. Here's hoping Thea turns into a powerhouse. Yeah, well, I know Thea is part of, well, I mean, we've seen it. She's part of a special event chain. So, yeah. There is a very good chance of Thayer being exceptionally strong. We have another character that's being built up as well, but she's still really young. Yes, yes, indeed, Fist. Hopefully catch you next time. Take care and have fun. But as for the rest of us on YouTube and Twitch, we're continuing the year. Right. We could go on another expedition. Could do some more trading. We still haven't set up another permanent trade route, so yeah, we've got the Hendati, the Genesni, Carandoli, the Rextanti, the Squat Oaks, the Vermandi on our side for trade partners. Yeah. Now, the Haran are hunters, but I don't know. Maybe we should go to the Lysangs. See if they will be willing to trade. Or establish a trade route. The problem is that we probably need to improve relations with people first. It looks like it's only the Old Owls and the Haran who are willing to trade with us at the moment. But we tried sending a trade envoy out to the Old Owls previously, and that didn't work out for us. What was Gorin's speciality? Known for their vineyard. Holy site dedicated to Arnaldo and Flamal. Maybe we should, rather than do a trade route, maybe we should send an emissary out to the Gorins. Try and get them on our side and get a trade route up with, set up with them. I think that's what we should do. Yeah. Looks like no one's really... no one's really giving us any information other than what we pretty much already know. So we'll give gifts to the Gorins. We'll give them maybe 30 goods. That is a lot of goods, but we have the goods to spare. So, yeah, I think we'll do that, and game, please. Behave. There we go. Corlaman. There we go. We'll send Corlaman out, give him an extra thane as we usually do, and there we go. I hear that weapon thanes of Carandoli killed that worm that the Lysangs were after us to kill for them. Many of them were hurt, but they gained a fabulous trophy. Well, there we go. That's the end of that. Oh. 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 Okay. A delegation from a clan far to the south in the Holy Country comes to seek your friendship. Their clan leader is called the Leadbreaker Clan. No, their clan is called the Leadbreaker Clan. All right, okay. We have a magical treasure that we wish to give you for safekeeping. It is called the Iron Spike. In exchange for the service, we give you a tapestry and a silver necklace. When we come to reclaim the spike, we will give you more silver and an even more valuable tapestry. Okay. It's hard to say what good the lead breakers could do for us. If we hold the treasure, we will benefit from its magic. They were content to remain in the land we felt obligated to flee. We can assume that they are well disposed towards our enemy, the Pharaoh. We have a little to fear from them. It will be hard for them to mount an effective raid all the way from the Holy Country. The gifts they give us are very valuable. Imagine how great the reward will be if we do what they ask. They've given us gifts. It would be rude to refuse them. If we ally with the Leadbreakers, we could intermarry with them. So, here we go. Do we agree to keep the spike for them? Ask if they serve the Pharaoh? Give them hospitality? Give them gifts? Or send them on their way? Well then. I'm kind of inclined to agree to keep the spike. Yord. But what was that? You think we should ask them if they serve the Pharaoh? Yeah. The Pharaoh commands everyone who lives in the Holy Country, they said, but we're not here for the Pharaoh. This is a matter of friendship between the Ainzoalgowns and the Leadbreakers. Odessa took the other ring members aside and said, I think they are not telling the truth. Well, well, well. Something's going on here. I have a feeling that they've, I think the falsity may be, that they are trying to garner a friendship between us and them. I have a feeling that they've done something to upset the Pharaoh, and they're now trying to cover their tracks. Maybe hiding evidence? It's hard to say. Pretty much everyone wants to keep the spike. And Thea here brings up a good point. If we hold the treasure, we will benefit from its magic. So, this would be a temporary treasure for us, and it might help our rather rough magic situation. Yeah, I suspect the Pharaoh will be looking for the spike. But, as Beneva said, we have little to fear from them. It will be hard for them to mount an effective raid all the way from the Holy Country. Might be worth the danger. I think so too. Because although we got absolutely trounced by those three sorcerers, which I believe were under the banner of the Pharaoh. I could be wrong. I think this, we can be prepared for an attack from the Pharaoh this time, if this is what I think is the case. So, okay, yeah, we'll keep the spike. We get lots of goods and we get a treasure. The Leadbreakers thanked us for our friendship. They promised to return for the spike soon, bringing the gifts due us. Okay, let's have a quick look. Iron Spike helps us as long as we oppose the trolls. Okay. So, if we fight trolls whenever we get the chance, then, well, there we go. This is going to help out, apparently. Second turn of Earth season. What do we do at this point? We've got someone going out to the Gorinths. Yeah. I think we send... No, I don't know, actually. We've sent an emissary out to the Gorinths, so we got that going on. Maybe it's a good idea to send someone out to explore a bit more of the map. We head out south of the Marsh Ducks this time. Yeah, I think we'll do that. We'll send Rundella out once again. And, yeah, we'll go south of this river here and give you a second weapon, Thane. There we go. The Gorins gave lavish praise to our gifts. They toasted me in their feasting hall, drinking far into the night and singing many rousing songs with me. I believe we can now consider Fuscandora, their chief, to be friendly. Okay, so we've got an adventurer going out and we are on better terms with the Gorins now. Let's use Dark Season to do a little bit of research. Now, what do we research at this point? Lots of options, but far fewer than there used to be. Let's sacrifice to Humact, see if we can get that true sword blessing. In peace, Humact states ready. In war, we sacrifice so that all ants battle thing can hack to victory. Nice. And there we go, we finally got the true sword ritual. Oh look! Trolls! Okay, fine. I think we will put some magic into this. So there are 9 dark trolls and 144 trollkin. Luckily our patrols spotted them and all 19 weapon thanes met them, as well as 138 of the feared. Okay, so we pretty strongly outmatch them. We don't outnumber... Oh, maybe we do outnumber them, actually. Yeah, we outnumber them. I think. No. I can't math good. Yeah, we barely outnumber them, and we definitely overpower them in terms of elites versus regulars. We won't sacrifice We'll kill as many as possible. Do we maneuver or do we charge? Personally, I think maneuver might play better, seeing as these guys fight in a rabble, if I remember correctly. Though a charge might work as well. Okay, we'll, we'll maneuver. The trolls charged right into the trap we had laid for them. There was a terrific fight. We drove the trolls from the battlefield, striking them down as they fled. So, lost one for one, but five of theirs were wounded. We lost a fighter, one of our footmen. They lost 24 trollkin. Wounded 39 of theirs to our 9. I think that was a pretty good defence. Well done, guys. And we opposed the trolls. I hope that counts as opposing the trolls. But with that, we've only got 2 wounded. Yeah, I think we'll keep Chalana's blessing on curing over healing, so... Okay. Got that done. Yeah, I think it's about time we got some more blessings from Elmore. We sacrificed in vain. Oh, Elmore. Our expedition to the west has returned. They say that this place should be called Beast Valley, for it's teeming with beast folk. Minotaurs, centaurs, duckmen, fox people, even wasp people. Rendella came across a small community of ducks. They gave our explorers tokens of friendship and said, "Many of your kind have offended us, claiming our land as their own. But you showed us a degree of respect. We wish to encourage this attitude in you." Oh dear. We're getting chummy with the beast folk. Oh dear. That's, not the best. Anyway. We've expanded our knowledge of the area somewhat, so that's good. But we have made friends with Gorins. Maybe they will be willing to trade with us now. Establish a trade route with the Gorins. Coleman, go do your thing. Oh, here we go. There's a great rock in the back pastures of your Tula. Randan Kulmarsson was walking by it one day when it spoke to him. It claims to be named Tarandriel, and to be the guardian spirit of the local hills. How do we react to this? Yes, duck friends. Yeah, unfortunately they are our ancestral enemies, so... Yeah, we can't be too chummy with the ducks, unfortunately. So yeah, here, do we commit to sacrifice annually to the spirit to worship it? Ignore this, it's not that important. Make a one-time sacrifice to the rock to befriend it. Test the spirit to see if you can trust it, or try to put the spirit back to sleep. This is an earth matter. Let an elder priestess handle it. Just like men, spirits can lie. I can determine the truth if it, of its words. Perhaps a hill spirit would watch over us, causing marauders to lose their way. That would be pretty neat. Propitiation of spirits. I've never encountered that word before. Of spirits is like a trade deal. Let me see what the spirits will give us if we worship it. Whatever you do, don't offend it. When a guest arrives, he needs hot food and cold drink, and dry clothes. Okay, well, I think off air here is probably onto something here. We probably should test the spirit to see if we can trust it. We'll get off here to do it. He says he can do it, so we decided that it spoke true and it would be able to protect us. Okay. Interesting. If we befriend it, it will do us some good. If we're willing to worship it, it will help us year in and year out. Okay. Well, we could commit to an annual sacrifice. It's not like we're struggling so much anymore. Yeah, okay, yeah, Ellie, you're on the same wavelength as me this time. So, yeah, we'll go with that. Who leads the rituals? Well, that would be the Arnalda priestess. How many cows do you want to sacrifice to the spirit this year? Let's give it 5 cows. That should be good. Yeah. Can't go crazy with it. Faradriel said we were under its protection, but expected further sacrifices in the future. Hmm. Okay. Taradriel. I'm not sure I like the look of that rune, but okay. Right, moving on. Storm season. I believe we've got someone coming out to the Gorins to try and set up a route now. I've already forgotten what I did just now to trigger that event. Oh, I see we have the Dragonute Wildler. That's interesting. I didn't notice that before. Hmm. Yeah, so this time I think I think once again we'll go on another bit of an adventure. Explore a bit more of the map. Maybe head out towards the dragon newts a little more. Maybe we'll find some kind of clan or something of dragon newts. Who knows? Mandela, you do your thing. We'll send you up. Yeah, they might be good. Caravan is back from the Gorins. Although I made a small profit, I could not convince them to set up an ongoing trade relationship. Okay. They were recently overflown by 3 dragons and were concerned. Oh dear. Okay, well. It's the end of that turn. Very well. This year, Ainzoalgown clan. I can't even say our own clan name. It's depressing, that is. Managed to achieve the following. 33 babies were born. We initiated 19 children as adults. The clan has 1 fewer person and 11 fewer head of cattle and 1 fewer horse than we did last sacred time. Okay. We produced 8,264 and ate 939 bushels of food. We ate... and 154 were lost due to spoilage. Crafters produced 123 cows worth of goods, and the market made 64 cows worth of goods. Maintaining our shrines and temples took 31 cows, and goods worth 62 cows. We're really going through them, aren't we? Our god talkers say that the omens indicate a typical harvest. They saw many ravens and suspect that there will be battle later in the year. Oh dear. But there we go. I think we'll hold back on the mysteries this year then. We'll carry on with the point in trade and 2 points in war. If there's going to be fighting this year. Anyway, I think that is that. Let's proceed. Maybe an event will kick off and we can end it on an interesting event. No, we won't. Okay, fair enough. Well, in that case, I think it's time for me to say goodbye for now. It's been a fun ride, but yes, my throat is getting more than a little scratchy, so... probably a good idea for a rest. Hope to play a bit more King of Dragon Pass later on in the week. Who knows when that'll be, but... maybe. Maybe Tuesday, maybe Wednesday. We'll see. But anyway, for those of you on YouTube, take care and have fun.